I used to worry so much about Brody being selfish or lonely, but now I've changed my mindset around that.
Brody is Claire's firstborn.
He is a really bubbly, bright, energetic 3.5-year-old. I've always known that I wanted to be a mum. I've wanted that since I was a little girl and I used to play with my dolls. I thought, I really want to have 3 children.
But it wasn't until she reached her late 30s that Claire was able to start her family.
Given that I was edging towards 40, there's a lot of pressure on women to think about the quality of their reproductive function and system.
Her journey into motherhood took a difficult path.
It quickly took a turn and Brody was actually stuck. That resulted in an emergency C-section and 4 failed epidurals. I was physically quite unwell and mentally a bit broken.
Eventually seeking help, Claire was diagnosed with severe postnatal depression and PTSD, along with a chronic illness triggered by her birth trauma.
Sorry. I think it felt a bit like a failure. It felt like I'd failed at the first year of motherhood. I remember thinking, oh my goodness, there's no way that I can ever do that again. There was a lot of grief around it, that that wasn't going to be my future and that we weren't going to have that 2.4 family that I had dreamt of my whole life.
Claire's family are not alone. The number of single-child families in Australia has doubled in the past 40 years, and it's a trend that's growing across the world. In the EU, triangle families are the most common, making up 49% of households with kids.
Because they're feeling more empowered. We've got choices now, our lifestyle choices.
Parenting expert Dr. Rosina says one-and-done families might soon become the norm, especially with rising infertility rates.
We might want to have career choices or do more travel. We might not have the support that we need to raise more than one child.
For the Hunt family, planning their future always involved being one and done.
I was an only child myself, and I had a really great experience, and I didn't think that I missed out by not having siblings. We both wanted to maintain our careers as well as our lifestyles.
For me, initially, the drive was almost financial, thinking about how tough it is these days for kids to get into a house. And I love the idea of being able to leave everything we have behind for one child and really making sure she's established.
As a trio, the family have been afforded the luxury to travel the world together and embark on many an adventure.
Could you show everyone your tan?
Staying in a villa and a 5-story hotel.
Oh, yeah.
A lot of people said we would change our mind, and I think then observing us as a family never followed that up, because they could see that we were so happy and could see the benefits that we were really enjoying.
But having just one child brings up the age-old stereotypes that only children grow up lonely, are less socially adapted and spoiled.
The first president of the American Psychological Association concluded back then in the late 1800s that being an only child was a disease into itself. And unfortunately, it wasn't very good research.
And modern research negates this theory. An American study found only children perform just as well as kids with siblings when it comes to intelligence, academic achievement, and social skills.
I always think of naughty Stanley Hall, because he was the one that started all of this and it wasn't even founded.
As more households embrace triangle families, the idea of being an only child could well be an advantage.
Being able to give all of my time and energy to one, I feel like I can give it my best shot. I can be the best dad that I can. Sometimes Remy gives us a bit of attitude about not giving her any siblings, but it's fleeting. She's a really creative kid.
We have to go downstairs.
Yeah, I'll go down the slide.
She's got lots of hobbies. She's got stage school and she's got swimming. We don't want to spoil her too much either. So, you know, I think it's important to get bored as well. I think that's when she gets really quite creative.
Aw, look at that.
Claire and Heather say it's time to start removing the stigma that's associated with having only children.
I think it's really important that people understand how amazing a family of 3 can be, a family with just one child. we've chosen it. But if you can't, please be rest assured that you'll have an amazing family experience. Your child won't be disadvantaged.
I feel confident that he is going to grow up as a really happy, healthy, sociable and generous, kind person. And I don't think he needs a sibling to do that.
They definitely still prevail, and people still feel them, even though it is becoming increasingly the norm and there is no research to back it up.
And I love the fact that the research was done by someone in the 1800s who made a bit of it up. Not a lot of empirical stuff going on there. You've got your gorgeous daughter. Yeah. It's interesting, isn't it, the assumption that you're going to have another one? You're already getting those questions?
Exactly. People wait, I reckon a year, and then they start saying... And maybe it's to do with age. I'm heading towards my mid-30s and people worry that you're kind of running out of time if you want to have more. But there is an assumption that, I mean, even the term only child suggests that there's something deficient about the one.
Yes.
Which is, it's, you know, I think it's out of date.
And I've got plenty of friends who said that if they had have had their second one first, they would have only had one.
You know what's great about too, though? It's nice to have a babysitter in the house. That's all.
Yes, this is true.
Free labour.
And it gives them someone else to fight with, not just you.
Yes.
That's great.
That's wonderful.
Yeah. I mean, they're the advantages you need to think about.